action figures, where athletes, artists, and musicians come together to show us why SoCal is so cool. I'm Brent Weber, and today a story of inspiration from Jesse Billauer, Life Rolls On organization, helping those who've run into some life-changing accidents get back on their track towards good life. And also, we'll be sitting down with the man and his best friend, Scott Chandler, and his dog, Zoe, talk about tow-in surfing for man and beast. They're not the only superheroes with us today. My personal favorite, Rana Townend, is here to tell us about the artists and musicians.
Thanks, Brent. Well, today we'll be visiting with our guest artist, Drew Brophy. He's going to show us some of his wonderful works of art and show us his surfboard that he's working on right now. So you'll get to see the process that he goes through and a finished surfboard at the end of the show. And our guest musicians for today are Ashley Loyd and the Sagimites. We'll check them out later.
Say that 10 times real fast, right? Sagimites. Well, we're going to hear the lovely sounds as we continue on Action Figures. Sarah Reinertsen is like a lot of multi-sport athletes. You just got to come to Southern California to train where the weather is great. You got everything you need, mountains, oceans, and really cool people. Sarah Reinertsen is one of those people. Grew up in New York, you live in California, back and forth a little bit, but as a triathlete, this is the place to be, right?
This is the place. This is triathlon Mecca, I think.
Now for you, there is one part of your story that you gotta get to right off the bat. You're not like everybody else.
No, and I'm the first woman on an artificial leg to attempt the Hawaii Ironman, and I hope to be the first woman to finish this October.
But you were born, you had a birth defect, I understand, mm-hmm. and you tried and tried and went through a lot of pain as a youngster before ultimately the decision to have your leg taken above the knee. And tell us what life was like for young Sarah.
Well, when I was born, one leg was shorter than the other, and so for many years I used to wear a brace that sort of evened the length of my limbs out, and I got on in that way till I was 7 years old, and it was an elective surgery, but we opted to amputate so that I could take advantage of better prosthetics that were out there to help me live, you know, life without limitations. About 4 years later, when I was 11 years old, I started running, and that was my sport for many, many years.
Running, and you haven't stopped running since. You've added, mixed a couple of other things in there. Let's put this in perspective in Hawaii. Tell everybody again what we're talking about with the Hawaiian Ironman.
An Ironman is a 2.4-mile swim, 112-mile bike, followed by a 26.2-mile run. So overall, 140 miles of swimming, biking, and running in the heat and the wind.
I was going to say, we're not talking about pool mileage or gym biking or anything of the nature.
Yeah.
Conditions for the Ironman are
brutal.
Are brutal, and you've had a go at it. Tell us about that.
I did. I attempted the Hawaii Ironman last October in 2004, and felt going into the race, I felt really strong, well trained. I'd been living here in California, spending a lot of time swimming, biking, running, and on race day, I finished the swim in an hour 30, got on the bike. But it was a really, really windy day. I mean, people said I picked the worst year to do it. And we had headwinds going both ways. And I got sick out on the bike at the last 30 miles. I was dehydrated, puking, and came into that transition area 14 minutes too late. They have cutoffs. So if you don't finish the bike by 5:30 in the afternoon, they won't let you onto the run. And so I came into transition and my day was done there. I went right to the medical tent and I didn't get to run that marathon across that finish line. So I say I did Ironman light and I'll be back for full Ironman this year.
We talk a lot about who our heroes are. We say, you know, our heroes are just like us, only cooler. That's what I say about my friends who come here. What about you when you were little? You know, who were your heroes?
You know, that's what is part of my work that I do now with some of the charities like Challenge Athletes Foundation, is I really didn't have very many heroes. Right. I really couldn't relate to some of the sports stars that we'd see on TV because they weren't disabled like I was, and they didn't really walk in my shoes. And so for them, you know, big deal that they play basketball well, you know, it's just, or big deal that they can run, or it just, because I couldn't relate to them. But I did have some mentors growing up. Patty Rossbach, she was a marathoner with one leg, and she's not well known to, you know, the general public, but for me, she was she might as well have been Michael Jordan, because to know a woman on an artificial leg who did marathons, I mean, she opened up that possibility for me. So what I do today is I do a lot of mentoring and working and holding bike clinics to teach people with prosthetics how to, you know, bike, how to swim, how to run. And you know, in some ways, I hope to be a role model for the next generation of disabled athletes.
We can find out more about that on your website.
On my website, iamsarah.org.
I am Sarah with an H.
Sarah with an H.
Don't
exactly.
Want, because you know, you're going to get something else probably. Yeah. Iamsarah.org. Sarah Reinertsen is our guest on this edition of Action Figures. Good luck.
Thank
we expect
you so
to
much.
See you crossing that finish line.
Definitely.
In Hawaii this year.
Thanks.
Sarah Reinertsen, our guest on Action Figures.
Feel the sun's rays on my face, the gentle breeze blows there.
My heroes when I was growing up was Dara Torres and Summer Sanders. I was a swimmer, so I definitely looked up to other swimmers, female swimmers. The thing that's great is I try to tell all the kids is we may look like superheroes because we do some crazy things in our sports, but it hurts. You know, that last 50 of my 200 breaststroke, it hurts just like anybody else's hurt.
I started swimming because of Amanda Beard, and so whenever I see her, she swims on our team. She swam on Nova with me, and I think she's one of the greatest swimmers there is. Every time I swim in the lane with her, I'm just really excited, and she's really the only athlete I'm ever like awestruck by.
You know, you just gotta put your heart and soul into it and really go for it, and no one can tell you that you can't do it or take your dreams away from you, so you just gotta defy all odds and go for it.
She's pretty amazing, and all that she's done, and beautiful girl too, so I think it's Amanda Beard, just all the way for me.
Ashley Loyd and the Sejamites on Action Figures. We've got it all for you. Great music, athletes, and of course, artists. One of the most unique on the planet is with our own Rana Townend right now. Rana.
Thanks, Brent. I'm here today on Action Figures with internationally renowned artist Drew Brophy. He's working on a piece right now, just finishing it up.
Yeah, I'm just adding a little white highlights. It's the last thing I do, and makes the fish come alive a little bit.
Add a little contrast and color, and then finish it up with the white.
Yeah, it looks good.
You brought some other pieces with you today, so can you go ahead and explain them? What's your inspiration for them?
Mainly, I brought the surfboard today. My roots are in surfboards. I first started airbrushing boards, and then I eventually progressed to doing all kind of design work and painting for surf companies and all kind of companies.
Did this start out more as a hobby, or did you always want to be an artist just for your career?
Well, I was a surfer, so I was just a guy that loved to surf, I loved the ocean, and I started painting them on my surfboards, and before long companies were saying, well, why don't you airbrush our boards, and now it's just become a full-time job.
Nice, and I understand besides painting on your boards and canvas and all these other things, you also do a lot of licensing too, so you can find your products all over.
Yeah, pretty much it's just evolved, you know. Surfing's become very popular in surf art, and so they all want to, you know, have different things, and we do
children's books, it looks like, mailboxes.
Yeah, a little bit of everything, and sometimes I forget we do so much. But mainly, you know, we just want to make things fun and decorate people's products if people like them. And
your art definitely portrays fun and happiness in it. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Thanks. Back to you, Brent.
Afraid to move from that same spot that you know so well. Outside of the box of thinks and thoughts, that's as far as a fairy tale. Oh, wouldn't it be grand if I could love who I want? Wouldn't it be grand if I could say what I thought? Wouldn't it be grand if I could sing from my heart? Wouldn't it be grand?
Wouldn't it be grand if you could get invited to this party or had friends like Ashley Loyd and all the other folks who are with us today on Action Figures? Got another very cool friend to invite. Now, you might not know his name because contests, well, that's not really his bag. He does things like bag world record sharks on his longboard and try out new and gnarly things surfing, and also take his dog out on the waves. Yeah. I think Scott Chandler can do it all, and he's here to tell us all about it. Right. You got to be, that's a unique start. Let's start with the shark that made some news, actually. You know, I'm paddling out there every now and then. I see a beautiful dolphin praying that I don't see the man in the gray suit. You know, I don't care if he's this big. I don't want to see a shark.
I was actually out fishing with a friend of mine that plays for the San Diego Padres on his boat, and we were catching a few blue sharks and a couple makos, and I kind of did the thing, I'll catch one of these off my surfboard. So it was kind of one of those, I bet you will. So I pretty much geared up one of my tandem boards, one of my longboards, and put a milk crate on there and strapped it down with some rod holders and had the gaff and the poles and my spear gun and my cell phone in a waterproof pouch around my neck, pre-dialed 911 just in case anything went wrong. And then I had a friend of mine from Hawaii that went out on a jet ski. It's kind of a support boat. And I said, five of these things come up. I had a chum bucket, and I went out to specifically catch a shark. So I said, if five sharks show up, I'm jumping on the jet ski. And I basically caught a small one. I had something on the line, got a baby mako, and as I was reeling that up, the big one came up and tried to eat the little one. So I actually got the little guy off the hook and then rebaited the hook and threw it, just tossed it right to it, because by that time it was coming around me and bumping at the chum bucket. So got him on the line and it took off, and then after that it was a 3-hour ride. So I'm an adrenaline junkie, and I guess it was the summertime and I was looking for some kind of adrenaline rush. So.
I mean, I've heard about tow-in surfing, but towing on a shark is a whole nother ballgame. Right.
And it towed me, believe me.
You're coming along at the right time in the history of the planet, because tow-in surfing is really, really taking off, and what it's allowing guys to do is push their surfing, push their bodies to limits that hadn't been done before, and just get you to spots that you used to have to dodge bullets to even get at. You guys do a little bit of that, don't you? You have your own secret spots.
Yeah, we do. We have a few spots, and of course, it's nothing you just go, hey, I'm going to go tow surf into 50, 60-foot waves, and something you just go out and do. It takes a lot of practice and a lot of experience, And we have a few spots that we train at. We do a lot of training. A lot of people don't realize that there is that much training involved, as far as, when you're surfing, being towed, or you're towing, you switch off, you partner up and you switch off. You're responsible for your partner's life. So I think it takes a lot of discipline and training to be at a stage where if there is an emergency, that you can deal with it at an instant, because, as it's not flat water.
Right.
So you're dealing with, 30-foot white water in between sets, and It's a heavy thing. And it's still in the infant stage, so it's only going to grow.
It's like freight train. I mean, really, isn't it?
Last winter I was in Washington, Oregon. Flew to Maui, surfed Jaws, and then flew home and did the Cortez Banks, which is 100 miles straight out here, all in about a week and a half. So basically chasing swells.
Speaking of chasing, you got a friend named Zoe. That normally, if in a normal dog's world, chasing balls, chasing cats, chasing waves, tell us about your four-legged friend and how she gets headlines.
So, come here. Come up here. Come on, up. This is my dog, Zoe. She's pretty much becoming a celebrity in my area as far as surfing. I took her out on my tandem board fishing with me to get her used to the water, mm-hmm. and she just loves the water. She likes, if I splash water, she'll bite at it. And I put some
don't do that. The ratings are not yet in.
I put some hydro turf, which is a traction pad, on the nose of my longboard and took her out, and I've got it now. I had her out last night. I tell her, a wave's coming, get ready. She runs up to the nose, sits right there on the hydro turf, and we're sitting out with everybody else and ride straight to the beach, and she's begging for more. So yeah, she's not into chasing balls. She likes chasing balls. She likes chasing squirrels better.
There you go.
But she's into surfing, definitely. She's making a name for herself.
I just thought of something, though. Have you ever seen that footage of the skiing squirrel? You get a skiing squirrel in front of the surfing dog, man, you got a show. That's reality TV.
I was thinking about getting maybe a pet rat or something in a little pack on her back, so all three of us could go.
The next question that comes to me is, what do you do for a living, man? Because you got some time on your hands.
I actually have a surfboard company. I manufacture surfboards, and lucky enough to to have the talent that I was given to do all this and be paid for it.
Chandler Surf, and we can find it on the internet, I'm guessing.
You can, well. ChandlerSurf.com.
Scott Chandler, our guest. Zoe, stealing the show. And friends on Action Figures, Jesse Billauer is with us. We talk about this show being about the people, the athletes, the artists, the musicians, and those who make Southern California so cool. Jesse's a big part of all those communities, I think. He's made friends, and he's also a huge part of the surfing community, and not necessarily because of what a great surfer you were anymore, right? You were good,
but only because of that.
Life changed for you a few years back, and every interview kind of has to start there. With how you wound up in that contraption. Nobody wakes up one day and says, you know, I think I'll spend the rest of my life in a chair, wheelchair.
For real. Yeah, man. Right before turning professional in surfing, I was practicing up at Zuma Beach in Malibu, like 6 to 8 foot day, really good, glassy, big barrels. Breaks close to shore, so it's kind of really shallow. But just pulling the barrel backside, and I came out, wave hit me in my back, and I didn't have time to put my hands up, and I went head first into the water and hit my head on the sandbar, and my whole body went numb and tingly, and I was just floating face down in the water. Yeah. I mean, luckily a wave turned me over, but when I called for help, all my friends just thought I was kidding, so nobody came over to help me. And then some more waves took me over the falls, and finally a friend came over and I just said, you gotta keep my head above water, else I'm gonna drown. And then I remember being up on the sand, you know, and I knew it was serious.
Well, it is serious. You suffered, tell us about what the doctors wound up finding out.
Yeah, so I broke the 6th vertebrae in my neck, and I became paralyzed from like my mid chest down, and called a quadriplegic, you know? But I figured, like, man, if I could still move my arms, I wanted to surf. So I figured a way to rig up a board, and now Al Merrick makes my boards, and I ride laying down on my stomach. And, you know, I started off surfing like 1 to 2 foot waves, but now, last year I surfed North Shore, Sunset Beach, Hawaii, 10-foot face. It was just crazy, but I made it, and just looking forward to going to, I'm gonna be going to Fiji with Hurley. I'm trying to get a barrel at restaurants or somewhere because I want to get the cover of Surfer Magazine.
You know, every little kid grows up here wanting to get the cover of Surfer Magazine, and most everybody would go, but you get that barrel there, you got it, man. It's a lot.
Oh, yeah, I already told people, man, if I get a barrel, and I'm not on the cover of Surfer or Surfing Magazine, they're gonna have a lot of protesters outside, man.
Life rolls
picket.
On is
picket
the
signs.
Yeah, exactly. We saw some picket signs
with
out here.
My photo on it.
Exactly. Life Rolls On is kind of rolled out of this, and I'm guessing that you found out after your accident that you weren't alone out there, and now other people have a place to turn to find out that they're not alone, those that this happens to.
Yeah, well, it was good. You know, after I got hurt, realized why not start this company to raise money for spinal cord research. And then I've been doing this for the last 5 or 6 years, traveling, doing motivational speaking, inspiring a lot of people. But this year we just expanded. Now I wanted my foundation to reach out to other extreme sports. Mm-hmm. So instead of just surfing, now we're reaching out to motocross, BMX, snowboarding, skateboarding, and wakeboarding, mm-hmm. and finding athletes that are injured in those areas to put them back in their sport and let them do what they did before.
Pushing ourselves is something I think all of you guys are. We heard a little bit earlier, when I say you guys, I mean our action sports athletes. We heard from Scott Chandler a few minutes ago, called himself an adrenaline junkie, you know, and I think surfers are that, and I think obviously that's helped you a lot, but there's a certain will that's gotten you to where you are now that maybe if you weren't a surfer, if that wasn't part of your community, it might not, you know, it's something that's part of you, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it took me 3.5 years after my injury to get back surfing, but it'll take a lifetime to take me out, you know? I might be skinny, but I got big lungs to, you know, ride some big waves, and hey, I made it this far, so I'm just looking forward to scaring a lot of people and having fun at the same time.
Jesse, Bill Auer has earned those. So let's see, you know, Al Merrick, he's got Tom Curran, Jesse, Bill Auer, you know.
No, no, now, hey, what I'm stoked about is Al Merrick has signature series boards, but only Kelly Slater, Rob Machado, and then in Japan he has Kalani Rob. But now I just worked my way in. I got the Jesse, Bill Auer Life Rolls On handicap model. So anytime anybody is in a wheelchair or something, orders a board, they're going to get the Jesse, Bill Auer model. That's sweet. Solid. So I'm just surfing, man, living, trying to enjoy my life as much as I can. Whether I'm sitting down, it's all good, you know? But I have to say thanks to all the people that helped me out. Without them, I wouldn't be able to get to point A to point B. And, you know, just like that, helping people out, sharing is all good. But whatever.
Stepping to Liquid had to be a great experience, and we got to talk about that because Dana Brown, of course, it's this century's best surf film so far. It's something that he definitely did his dad's name proud, and you got a chance to spend a lot of time with your buddy Rob Machado in that. You guys had a segment together, and it's really a beautiful way to kind of tell a story.
Yeah, that's really helped out with Life Rolls On. It's been helping out with me. A lot of people really love that part, but like I said, it's all about surfing and enjoying that moment in the water. For me, it gives me my sense of freedom and peace, and just like, I always depend on people all the time, and I always have to have kind of people around, but when I'm on the wave, I'm like by myself and in my own little world, and it's so peaceful and just cleansing. And I'm a Pisces, so I can't, my gills would close up if I was too far away from the beach, so I try to get in there as much as possible. And for the past 3.5 years, I've been filming a documentary movie on my life. It's called Jesse's Story, and the last footage is gonna be from Fiji. And that will be done in July, so I'm stoked about that.
And I saw there is some of that. You had a little bit of that on the website, right?
Yeah, I got a trailer. I have me swimming in a cage next to 12 to 15 foot great white sharks. I got Christopher Reeve in the movie, Jack Johnson, Ben Harper, amongst other surfers, Rob, Kelly, and you know.
A lot of people will spend the first 26 years of their lives just wishing that they could do what Jesse Bill Auer has done with his. Life Rolls On. Thanks, man, for being here, for being an inspiration to us, and keep plugging.
Yeah, man, love life because life loves you, man. Never give up on your hopes and dreams, and as long as you follow your own destiny and create your own future, man, a lot could be succeeded, accomplished. For chisel my nizzle off the spizzle for Snoop Dogg.
And with that, Rana, tell us about the band.
Yeah, man, break it down. Music and me is a creation.
Now we're here with our musicians for the day, Ashley Loyd and the Sagemies. So tell me, where did you come up with that name?
Well, that's top secret.
Oh, so we have to wait to find out?
Possibly.
All right, so hopefully we'll find out one day. So how long have you guys been playing together?
We just recently got together and formulated this group, and we're pretty excited about it.
Cool, and how would you describe, like, what type of music you guys usually play?
Kind of folky, bluesy, jazzy.
That sounds about right. And what are you going to play for us today?
We're going to play a song called I've Got Luck.
Very nice. We're looking forward to seeing lots more. So let's go ahead and hear it.
Thank you. All right.
Thanks.
I've got lots of stories to tell, but I don't know them yet. I got lots of friends to love, but I haven't met them all. No time finds the answers. I know. Is this the end or is it the beginning? 'Cause I feel that I am not done. Is this a start or is it all the finishing? Well, here I am, I'm ready for more fun. 'Cause I've got lots of stories to tell, but I don't know them yet. I got lots of friends to love, but I haven't met them all. No time finds the answers. I know. There are so many flowers that I haven't yet smiled, and there are many sandcastles that I still have to build. More waves to ride. How will I spend my time before I say goodbye? 'Cause Cause I've got lots of stories to tell, but I don't know them yet. I got lots of friends to love, but I haven't met them all. No time finds the answers. I know, yes, I know. Oh, I know. Oh, I know. Songs, songs, songs. I need more words to fill all of my songs before I am gone. Pain, pain, pain. How will I fill my days? Will I paint them in a colorful way? Cause I've got lots of stories to tell, but I don't know them yet. I got lots of friends to love, but I haven't met them all. No time finds the answers. I know, yes, I know. But will I work all day to let the people know that there is more to life than just a cubicle? Will I exercise my mind, my mind, and make other people smile by using my life? Got lots of stories to tell, but I don't know them yet. I got lots of friends to love, but I haven't met them all. No time finds the answers. I know, yeah, I know. Whoa, time finds the answers. I know.
ActionFiguresTV.com. Find out how you can own this set of five autographed Drew Brophy surfboard prints. Jesse Billauer is going to tell us what you should do with them.
You got to put these over your hot tub jacuzzi, man, with candles, because Drew is the man, great artist. All the funds that are going to be raised from this are going to go to the Surfrider Foundation. So bet on these things, man. Good money, good cause.
And there you have it. I'd like to thank all of our guests for joining Rana and myself, Mr. Chandler,
Ms.
Loyd and friends. And of course, Mr. Brophy and Zoe are out surfing, but they're here with us in the spirit. You're watching Action Figures. Remember, as Jesse says, life rolls on. Go out there, make it good every day. We'll see you guys next time.
There's nothing better that I like to do. Lay here in the warm sand with you. Feel the sun's rays on my face. A gentle breeze blows there.